Well, it's certainly strange times in the entertainment industry at the moment, with all of the movies and cinemas around America being shut down for lockdown, which is obviously a great thing for all of us so that we can save lives and stay safe, but it is detrimental to the movie industry. Previously, the cinema numbers had gone down with the introduction of streaming services. Now more than ever, this is a hit that probably won't be easy to bounce back from. For the first time in recorded history, $0 were recorded at the box office. Poor movies that were actually released this year have really struggled with it. In fact, a lot of movies that had slated from April onwards have just been pushed back, some to November, others to early next year. Others are just TBD, to be determined at this stage. It was James Bond that was the first one to make that move and the rest followed. But as James Bond has aptly named its title, there is no time to die. But for the movies that already were released, like Onward, Birds of Prey, Invisible Man, Emma, after about 2 weeks, they've gone straight to video on demand, which is unprecedented in this time, but very necessary for the studios to make their money back. You can buy or rent these movies for $19.99. For some people, that's a little bit too much, but when you think about it, when you take yourself or another person or the whole family to the movies, you're paying for each ticket, so I believe it's trying to cover those costs. If you are looking to save money, there are free streaming services available, like Tubi.tv, and there's a bunch of movies to recommend, so coming at you right now, if you've got the kids at home and you're looking to entertain the family, watch Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
So they're aliens?
No, that's stupid. They're turtles.
Is there anything else we should know about them?
They're ninjas.
It came out in 2014 and made nearly $500 million at the box office. And funnily enough, this week, it is the 30th anniversary from when the first movie came out. Yeah, when I was a kid and I watched it. It's so cool to see that franchise is really lasting the test of time. If you are in a relationship and maybe things are a little bit strained considering you're spending a lot of time with your significant other, the cure for that is Sing Street.
What the hell, Rufina?
It came out in 2016. It has a 95% rating from Rotten Tomatoes, and it's all about a kid who's in Ireland, Dublin, in the 80s during a recession, and to find his identity, he joins a band. The soundtrack is fantastic. You get the likes of Hall & Oates, Duran Duran, and of course, The Cure, which is what this movie is. I guarantee you're gonna love it. If you're by yourself this quarantine, it can be a little bit tough. So the perfect movie to escape into is 2002's Minority Report.
9-6.
Directed by Steven Spielberg, starring Tom Cruise in what I will argue is one of his best movies. This movie is well ahead of its time, talking about the story of pre-crime, where they can actually find out about a murder before it's committed. The use of technology in this is just unfounded, and it's got a 90% rating on Rotten Tomatoes. So Tubi.tv has you sorted. It's a completely free streaming service, and they're my recommendations. Back to you, DBL.